season by starting flower and vegetable seedlings. Subscribe and press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from Urban Gardening. One important factor that will determine the degree of success is the potting media. To start your seeds, these two blends are perfect. You will get best result in 70% peat moss with 30% compost, and add 1 tablespoon fungicide powder to avoid any root problems. For the second mix, make 70% coco peat with 30% compost and add 1 tablespoon fungicide powder. Soil-less potting mixes are soft and will help the seeds to germinate faster without any hesitation, while garden soil will become hard after watering and will block seed germination. To start your seeds, take a 4 to 5 inch deep medium sized pot with holes at the bottom for drainage. Fill the pot with the seed starting mix. Now press it down with a flat object to make an even surface. Moisten the mix before you sow seeds in it. Flowers like petunia and ice plants have very small seeds, and it is better to mix some fungicide powder with them while planting. Now sprinkle seeds evenly over the soil surface. Seeds of petunia and ice plant does not need to be covered. Keep them open for better germination. Seeds of gazania and calendula needs to be covered for good germination. Cover seeds with a very fine layer of soil mix. Make sure to cover every single seed out there. After covering the seeds, water the soil mix thoroughly with a gentle shower. If temperature is below 28 degrees Celsius, then it is okay to keep the pot in full sun, but if the temperature is above 28, then keep the pot in a bright spot away from direct sun, and as seed starts to germinate, increase sunlight exposure to avoid laggy seedlings. Watering requires some care. You don't want to blast the mix and small seedling out of the container, so use a mister or just poke some holes in the cap of a water bottle and water your seedlings gently. When young seedlings seem to be growing healthy one day and dying the next, it is probably being caused by damping off. Damping off can affect the stems of seedling both below the soil line and above. To cure and to avoid this, just mix 1 to 2 tablespoons of systemic fungicide in 500 ml water and water your seedlings with this mix. Water gently and make sure to cover all the soil surface. It is better to repeat this process after every 25 days for healthy growth. Once seedlings are 18 to 20 days old, we can boost their growth by adding 15 to 20 granules of diammonium phosphate or 1/4 tablespoon of NPK. Add the quantity in 300 to 500 ml water and mix it well. Add 50 to 60 ml in one go and repeat this process after every 8 to 10 days. This process will provide the seedlings with the energy to get a jump start on their growth. And in few days, our seedlings will double in size. The general rule of thumb is that when a seedling has 3 to 4 true leaves, it's large enough to plant it out in the garden or in the pots as they show good response at this stage. To reduce shock to transplants, water them well before transplanting. If possible, transplant late in the afternoon or on a cloudy day. Now with the help of a gardening tool, gently pull the seedlings out. Make sure that the root ball remains intact to avoid transplant shock. You will want to maintain the root ball and any attached soil as best as you can. Seven to 8-inch diameter pots are perfect for seasonal flower plants. Make sure they have holes at the bottom for drainage. If holes are big, then it is better to cover them with small stones for effective drainage. Now fill pots with the soil mix. For final planting, we will use a mix of 50% garden soil, 30% compost and 20% fine sand or perlite. Firm the soil with your hand to remove any air gaps. When filling containers with the soil mix, don't fill the pot to the top. Leave about 1.5 to 2 inches space between the rim of the pot and the soil surface. This will help in effective watering as it provides a place to put water and not have it run over the edge. Dig a hole, set the transplant in place and gently firm the soil around the stem. Water well after transplanting and add more soil to fill up the holes if required. Now to avoid transplant shock, it is better to keep the pots in a bright spot away from direct sun for at least 2 to 3 days. After 3 days, we will shift them in direct sun. Pinching is a form of pruning. The biggest reason for pinching plants is to force the plant into a more full form. By pinching back, you force the plant to grow twice as many stems, which results in a fuller plant.
Pinch as close to leaf nodes as possible. Each time you remove a main stem, your plant will try to grow two new stems beneath the pinch or cut. It forces most plants to grow bushier and fuller rather than concentrating their energy on getting taller. When it comes to watering, there are no hard or fast rules. Water whenever soil starts to dry up. Keep the soil little moist at all times for constant growth. Avoid soggy and wet conditions, as too much moisture can be just as damaging to plants as too little. In general, early morning or late evening is the optimal time to water your containers, as this will give the plants some time to take up the water before the heat of the day kicks in. After every 15 to 18 days, add 18 to 20 granules of diammonium phosphate or mix 1/4 tablespoon of balanced NPK per 4 to 5 plants. Dig a small hole away from the plants and put around 20 granules of diammonium phosphate. Granular fertilizers are long-lasting and they will fertilize the plants with time. And within few days, you will see dramatic results. Keeping the soil rich promotes well-fed plants that produce healthy blooms. Deadheading refers to removing spent or faded flowers from the plant. Once a plant has finished flowering, it suspends the flowering process in order to form seeds. When you deadhead, the energy, strength, and nutrients that would have gone into producing new seeds generates more flower instead. This means you can get a second show or maybe several more over the course of the growing season. After deadheading, it is important to mix some fertilizer in the soil to boost new growth. Work it into the first few inches of the soil with a gardening tool and add water immediately after adding fertilizer. Perform deadheading as soon as the flower begins to fade. Some flowers like marigold, dock flower, dianthus, verbena, and others could bloom all season with regular deadheading.